Minor Scales, everything you need to know so you don't fail music class in 7 minutes. Minor scales are an important component of musical theory, analysis, composition, and technique. They have a different sound and structure from major scales, but are very closely related to them. Side note, it's important to note that familiarity with major scales and key signatures is fundamental to understanding minor scales. If you don't know those things before tackling minor scales, you're gonna have a bad time. Check the links in the description if you need to brush up on either of those concepts. Major and minor scales are so closely related that we say that every major scale has a relative minor scale and every minor scale has a relative major scale. Consider C major and its relative minor scale, A minor. Notice that they're built using the exact same notes. In fact, if we arrange the notes like this and combine the scales, it's clear that they're basically the same scale, just starting in a different place. We can also see this phenomenon on the piano. Here's a 2-octave C major scale, and this section of notes in the middle is an A minor scale. Some people like to think of the minor scale as starting on the 6th note of the major scale. Similarly, relative major and minor scales share a key signature. For instance, D major and its relative minor, B minor. Both have 2 sharps, F sharp and C sharp, which means you can also write these scales like this, with a key signature, instead of writing out the individual sharps. The easiest way to determine a scale's relative major or minor is to realize that the root or first note of relative major and minor scales are separated by 3 semitones. To find the relative minor of C major, go down 3 semitones, C to B, B to B flat, and B flat to A. So, A minor is the relative minor scale of C major, and C major is the relative major of A minor. Of course, it works backwards too. To find the relative major of E flat minor, go up 3 semitones, E flat to E, E to F, and F to G flat. G flat major is the relative major of E flat minor. Also, relative major and minor are separated by 2 letter names. In this case, E goes to F and then to G. Things get confusing if you try to compare E flat minor and F sharp major. Be careful, some people count the first note rather than the first semitone and end up only going up 2 semitones. From C sharp minor, they go 1, 2, 3, but that's only 2 semitones. Make sure to go 3 semitones up or down. So, the relative major of C sharp minor is E major. To remember which direction is which, think of the quality of the scales. Most people think of the major scale as a happy, bright sound, like the feeling of nailing the garbage can with a piece of trash from all the way across the room, and hear the minor scale as a sadder, darker sound, like the feeling of being left hanging on a high five while you try to congratulate your best friend who just nailed the garbage can from all the way across the room. So, to go from the major to the relative minor, go 3 semitones down, and to go from the minor to the relative major, go 3 semitones up. To write a minor scale, start with the root and write 8 notes, one on each successive line or space, ending on the same note you started. Now you need to know what key signature to use, so we find the relative major. Looking at the piano keyboard, we see that 3 semitones above E is G, and the key signature for G major is 1 sharp, F sharp. So, we add in the key signature, and that's an E minor scale. Now, it's important to know that there are actually 3 types of minor scales. So far, we've been looking at something called the natural minor scale. The natural minor is the easiest to remember and the easiest to write because it's the same as the major scale but starts on a different note, the 6th, which is 3 semitones down. The natural minor is unchanged, unprocessed, no additives, preservatives, or fillers. It's the natural minor scale. The next type of minor scale is called the harmonic minor scale. It's almost the same as the natural minor scale, but the 7th note is raised by a semitone. To change E natural minor to E harmonic minor, we go to the 7th note, D, and raise it by a semitone to D sharp. And that's the only difference between the natural and harmonic minor scales. To write the D harmonic minor scale, write out the notes, find out the relative major, 3 semitones up from D, F major, and add the key signature, which, for F major and D minor, is 1 flat, B flat. Finally, raise the 7th note by a semitone. C becomes C sharp. Notice that in minor scales, unlike major scales, you sometimes see sharps and flats in the same scale, in this case, B flat and C sharp. The raised note isn't necessarily sharp. It might go from flat to natural, like an E flat harmonic minor. To write that scale, write the notes, add the key signature from the relative major, which is G flat major, 6 flats. Then, check the 7th note. It's D flat because D is flat in the key signature. Then, raise D flat a semitone to D natural by adding a natural symbol. Finally, let's look at G sharp harmonic minor for one more special case. Write the notes, check your piano keyboard to see that the relative major of G sharp minor is B. Add in the appropriate key signature. Now, to raise the 7th note. It's already sharp, F sharp, so we actually use a double sharp, which just looks like an X. So, to write a harmonic minor scale, write a natural minor scale, and then raise the 7th note by a semitone. If the 7th note is flat, it becomes natural. If it's natural, it becomes sharp. And if it's sharp, it becomes double sharp. There's one other type of minor scale called melodic minor. It's a bit of a special case because unlike most scales, it's actually different on the way up and down. It starts the same way as the other scales. Write the notes, this time ascending and descending. Then add the key signature from the relative major scale. To make it melodic minor, raise the 6th and 7th notes by a semitone on the way up. In this case, A flat and B flat turn into A natural and B natural. Then lower them back down a semitone on the way down, so the A and B become flat again. Let's also look at F sharp melodic minor. The 6th and 7th are natural, so they get raised to sharp on the way up, and then on the way back down, they get lowered back to naturals. Finally, G sharp melodic minor. In this case, the 6th is E natural and gets raised to E sharp, and the 7th is already sharp, so it gets raised to F double sharp. On the way back down, they get lowered back to F sharp and E natural. And now for the big questions. Why are there three types of minor scales, and how do I remember which is which? The most complete and accurate answer is surprisingly complex and probably outside the scope of this video. But to give you some sense of the purpose of these scales, their origin, as well as how to remember which is which. The natural minor is the easiest scale to remember because it's the same as a major scale but starts on a different note. It's naturally occurring. It exists because it sounds nice, and composers use it a lot. But really, natural minor isn't the only scale you can make by playing a major scale from a different starting note. You can start on any note of the major scale, and each one has a specific name. These are called modes. The natural minor just happens to be a really commonly used mode. The harmonic minor scale exists for reasons related to, surprise, surprise, harmony. The raised 7th note creates more tension than the 7th of the natural minor, which is resolved when the 7th note moves to the root of the scale. You can also hear this in the chords associated with both scales. The raised 7th changes the quality of several chords, the most important being the chord built on the 5th note of the scale. Composers use the harmonic minor version of the 5 chord way more often than the natural minor version because it makes for a more compelling cadence. And that's why harmonic minor exists. The melodic minor scale is the scale that's different on the way up and the way down, much like a melody. A melody is more intricate than a simple scale and may have different notes on the way up and the way down. The reasons for the existence and structure of this scale are the most complex. But, like many things in music, the main reason is tradition. Over the years, composers have used this scale a lot. The melodic minor scale can be easier to sing and sight read, and composers like the way it manages tension and release. And that's why you have to know it too. So, to write a minor scale, write the notes, then find and write the relative major key signature. If the type of minor scale is natural minor, you're done. If it's harmonic minor, raise the 7th note by one semitone. If it's melodic minor, raise the 6th and 7th by one semitone ascending, and lower the 6th and 7th back down a semitone descending. And that's minor scales. Be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching!